Well, I think that there has to be a national wake-up call about the dangers of prescription drug use and abuse. And also, we all have to get educated about addiction and how it works, because there is just a tremendous ignorance, and it ends up, I think, contributing to the problem. For example, it was said by a friend, Whitney Houston's friend said, hey, she was drinking Thursday night, but she was happy and joyful. Well, let me say this, as a recovering alcoholic with 16 years of sobriety, and hopefully by April I'll have 17 years, when you are in recovery, you are not to have a thimbleful of anything that is mood altering. I do not even gargle with a mouthwash that contains even a trace of alcohol. I will not have a piece of food that has been cooked in alcohol, because even a drop can trigger a binge.
But Jane,
once you have that first sip, that even a tiny crumble piece of a pill, you lose control. And you essentially are not able to say no. It's like one drink is not enough, 1,000 isn't enough.
But Jane, doesn't everybody have their own recovery habits, their own way of doing it? I mean, we're not getting into the specifics of what is reported to have been found in a room, but some of these reports suggest that it's stuff that high-functioning, everyday people take, and this might just be regular prescription drugs someone needs for a regular ailment.
Well, it's a slippery slope. We are told as people in recovery that we are only to take a medicine when it is absolutely medically necessary, and then only for exactly how long it is absolutely medically necessary. And this is part of the problem. Doctors are ignorant about addiction. So they're giving people across America powerful narcotics that are highly, highly addictive, and then not realizing that they are turning people into addicts. This is a wake-up call to the nation. Again, we do not know what was found in Whitney Houston's system. So I'm not jumping to conclusions. But the fact is that she was in rehab less than a year ago. She checked herself back into rehab. A person who has been in rehab several times and last checked herself in less than a year ago should not be having anything to drink, no alcohol. And if Americans take that one thing away, then maybe that'll save other lives.
I wonder if, speaking as a former recovered addict yourself, you talk about what society could have done, if we could have done something to intervene. And does this speak a little bit to the way, I don't know, the way we all look at aging women in Hollywood? Do you think that's something that maybe Whitney Houston was suffering from?
Well, listen, I think all performers suffer from that. You're only as good as your last performance, and eventually your last performance isn't going to be that good because we age. Michael Jackson couldn't dance the way he did when he was a teen, and Whitney Houston couldn't sing the way she did when she was younger. And so if your entire self-esteem is based on your ability to perform, ultimately you're going to end up in a corner and feeling desperate. And so I think that we do have to look at the demands we place on performers and stars to be eternally youthful. We live in a disposable society, and we dispose not only of physical objects, but people when they pass their expiration date. And I think we have to rethink that as a culture.